I'm Terri Meyer, and today we're in beautiful Ohio. It's November, and it's in the mid-70s. We are blessed to have such a beautiful day, and I'm going to take advantage of it by being outside painting plein air. So behind me is an old Ford 100 truck that is going to be our subject today, and I want you to join me as we paint this together. Have my easel set up. I've done a quick sketch with pastel pencils in a light gray of the composition, and I'm just going to do a little panoramic of the property. And that's my little Kubota friend, my Sherpa that allows me to paint on location on many spots around the area, so I don't have to do hiking. Today is beautiful. There's very little wind. The sun is shining. I couldn't ask for a better day, so I'm looking forward to painting this afternoon. And I'll join you back at the easel in just a moment. Lost my camera there. What I'm doing right now is just blocking in. This is definitely pretty much all dark behind here. Slivers of light on this building, but for the most part, it's all dark in shadow. And there's a big tree off to my left that's casting a lot of this. And then this comes, this is all in shadow. Again, it's part of a tree. This is light here. So this goes out like this. This is in shadow. Okay. So I'm happy with getting that established. Next thing that I'm going to do is do my sky. And it's a really light blue. I'm gonna go a little darker than what I see it, because I noticed that the house that I painted a few days ago, I did it real light, and after I did it, it was too light, I thought. So I'm just gonna exaggerate the color on this one. And I'm going to add pink as it comes down toward the earth. That's way too bright. Let's see here. Which pink do I want? Kind of a... let's probably... it's too peachy. Let's try that. That's probably more along what I want here. I'm gonna come back and soften that. I can do it with my fingers.
Actually, there's a little bit of light yellow in this as well. I'm going to go ahead and put that in. And like that. Let's see if this color's better. And I'm just going to go back. It's a little bit lighter in color. If you can see that. It's that variation that gives the painting the dimensions. And now I'm going to go, it's too dark, I'm going to use a purple. I have a purple gray back here. Let me kind of reevaluate that. Kind of along this lines, but a little darker. Let's try. This is actually a gray green. Not quite what I want. I really need to get myself some more grays, I think. It needs to be just a little bit darker than this. So I think that's going to be too dark. I guess what I can do is I'll blend it with some other colors. Try to get that. It's too blue. Not happy with. Maybe if I go with this and then add a little more blue in it, that might be what I'm looking for. I don't want it too dark because then it's going to overpower and come forward in the painting. So I want to keep it soft. And a medium to light value. And as I've stated in some of my other videos, if you watch them, I always like to do a block in here in the very beginning. So I'm going to take my blending tool, my handy dandy blending tool. And these tree lines obviously way in a distance. And I'm still not sure about this color. So I'll probably tweak it after I get some of the other colors in. But it's important to put a variation of color that gives your painting an aliveness. If it's all just one solid color, it makes it kind of boring. It would be like playing the same note in music over and over again, and it would be very boring. And another thing that you want to do is you want to vary the tree line. So there's some areas that are higher than others. And then I'm just gonna come back in with this sky color and give it more variation. We live close to an airport, so you're gonna hear a lot of planes flying overhead. It's a small airport, and we have a lot of skydivers that jump on the weekends. So I wouldn't be surprised if there's not a skydiver falls out of the sky while I'm painting today. Okay, now there's a color that I've been using that I really have liked for the grass color. And I believe this is it. This is in light. It's kind of a gray green, and I'm thinking maybe I got it a little too light, so I'm gonna go ahead and soften that with the. And there's rolling hills here, so the hill does go up like this. I didn't finish putting this all in the shade here. I didn't do that. There's a nice tree. It's just about in here. And there's also there's a bunch of hay bales along this tree here. Like this color, but it's got a little more blue in it, so I don't have that color, so I'm gonna have to, there we go, that's more like it. I'll just add some of this peachy color in there. I'm adding some red here. So when I put the green in for the grass, it's not overly green. It tones it down slightly. And I apologize, I keep sniffling. I have some kind of allergies going on here and I can't seem to get moved past it. Now the grass in the foreground is going to be brighter. It's getting hit by sunlight. There's actually quite a few leaves on the ground. I'm not sure that I'm going to put that in yet. So I better get my... getting a little wind right now. It was just quiet and no wind at all, and now that's part of the plein air. You have to deal with the elements as they arise, and the wind is really starting to pick up. So I'm going to tie this down a little bit better. Okay. Actually, back here, there's a lot of leaves in front of this, so I'm going to annotate that right now with some brown and rust color. And there's actually a lot of leaves. Go ahead and annotate that. And go ahead and put the fender in here. And this is very dark right here. Looks like it might be where the license plate once was. So I'm going to put that in. And I know you can't see what I'm painting, so when I edit the video, I will go ahead and put a reference photo. I'm gonna go a little darker on that blue. It's so little, because this is all. It's actually more of a gray. Is all, there's a lot of shadow under here. It grounds the truck, so I need to get that established. Of rust on the tailgate. So I don't lose it. I'm seeing a lot of this yellow as the paint has started to erode away. It's showing the underlying colors of yellow. And let's see here. There's also right here, and it's too light. I guess maybe I should just go and put this green in and then layer my colors over top of it. Because there's white showing through. I'm starting to get too fussy already, so I'm just going to continue moving through this. And I'm just looking at this and that's too bright, so I have to think about what I'm going to turn this down with, maybe. is on light. So I'm just going to go ahead and lay this all in so it pops. This is the door. The lighting's changed since I have started. And I was looking for the right color. This is it. I thought it was a white, but it's actually like more of a pink.